Hello, my name is Arnaud Delorme, and this is part two of the EEG preprocessing using EEGLAB. This part is about importing events and channel locations. So we saw part one was about importing into EEGLAB, and now we're at part two. So most of the time, event information is already with your EEG dataset. It's been collected using an additional channel, depends on the amplifier, but most often you have some information about events already. What happened is that sometimes this information is in additional channel and then has not been extracted from that channel. So we'll see that example in a second. Or sometimes it can also be in a text file. Like, for instance, if you're using the MATLAB psychophysics toolbox, you might have saved some information in text file from an event channel, already mentioned that, or from another software like presentation, e-prime, neuroscan, event file. And then what happens when it's from another software is that your EEG amplifier only have limited information. It just have a number for the event. And then you want to associate more information. So you would need to fuse these events. Sometimes you don't have some of the events. You might just have the stimulus, which are saved along with the EEG file, but reaction time are not saved along in the EEG file. So you want to put back the reaction time in the along with the EEG data so you can process it. And what EEGLAB will do is that it will import these events and then calculate possible discrepancy in the sampling rate in the order of 0.1% and then align this event as best as possible. Here we'll just see the simple example of importing from a data channel. So if you call this menu here, it's going to tell you, it's going to ask you what's the number of the event channel. So for instance, it could be 73 here. That's usually the last channel is the event channel. If it's noisy, for example, you can apply a logical formula to the data. You can extract on the leading edge, the training edge, or both. You can also extract the duration of the event. You can erase the old events or add new events. So if you press OK on that menu, and then you go look at the data, you don't delete the event channel. Here only one channel is represented. There is usually all the other EEG channel as well at the same time as the event channel. But just for representation purposes here, only the event channel is represented. And we can see here vertical lines. So the vertical lines of different colors are the event, and the black trace is the event channel. So here EEGLAB has extracted different events, and the color of the event depends on the amplitude of the channel, and it has extracted them on the leading edge of the signal. If there was a checkbox here, all event of the same type, if you click that checkbox, then it will only extract one color, one type of event, irrespective of the amplitude. Once you're done importing events, you should see events here. It's going to tell you the number of events that have been imported. Now, what about channel locations? Well, to import channel locations, you go to the Edit menu, Edit, and then Channel Locations. And the first, you have a pop-up window, and it asks you, do you want to use the channel labels to figure out some channel locations for these electrodes, for these channels? Very often in the raw data file, there is a channel locations, there is channel labels associated with these channels. So even though they might not have locations, they sometimes have channel labels, and we can use these labels to figure out some template location. So that's what this menu is about. And if you press OK, it's going to pop up. Now we have the channel labels and we have the location of the channel. We have the location in three different coordinate system. We have polar angle and polar radius, so that's planar, polar coordinates. We have Cartesian 3D coordinates, X, Y, Z. We have spherical coordinates. And the reason we have all these coordinate system is different types of channel location format use different coordinates, so we wanted to support them all. So that's why you have all these channel coordinates. You also have this menu, read location. So if you have an external location file that was provided by the manufacturer, for example, you can import it here. Or if you have scan electrodes using Polyhemus, for example, you can import them here. There's a new development, which is it's an extension, EEGLAB extension called Get Channel Locks, and that allows you to import channel locations if from a special format. It's if you have an iPad and you film around the head, you can figure out the channel location. So this plugin will allow you to import this type of information into EEGLAB. Once you have channel location information, you can press one of these two buttons, plot 2D or plot 3D, to visualize your channels in 2D or 3D. Here in two dimension, we see the head, the nose here is represented by this, and then the ears are represented on the side and the channels. Some of the channels are outside the head because they're eye channels. If you import channels which you have scanned, you might also want to apply some transformation. For instance, you can optimize the head center. So when you scan channel coordinates, very often the head center is not optimal. So you might want to select a subset of channels and fit a sphere. And then the new center is the center of that sphere, and you can exclude some of the channels when you do that. You can also rotate axis. For instance, if you import your channels and the nose is along the wrong direction, you can rotate the axis. You can also rotate axis using nose along plus X here or plus Y. You can, with this menu, rotate axis, you can also rotate in three dimension. And then you can also select the channel types. If you have only EEG channels, you can set them to all the EEG channels. Or if you have autonomous channels like heart, respiration, you can also assign them different types. And there's specific types for different types of channels. And this is useful, for instance, when you're filtering data, you can select different types or for all the type of processing. So now, then you press OK, and now if you look at the interface in front of channel locations, it says yes, these channels have been imported. The last thing I wanted to mention in this short tutorial is about a menu that's called About This Dataset that contains information about the dataset. So if you click on this menu for one of the tutorial datasets, you have information about that data set that tells you how the data was acquired, and you can add some notes yourself for people that might process this data set in the future, or for yourself when you would come back to this data set. So here I've just started MATLAB, and now I'm starting EEGLAB, and I'm going to load again that data set that has been saved in EEGLAB format just after being imported. So that's in sample data, EEGLAB underscore data dot set, again in the sample data subfolder of EEGLAB. I press OK. This data set doesn't need events to be imported. That's the event menu, because it already has events. And we can see the event, and when we plot them, we can see them here, for example, square reaction time. But we will import channel locations. When we look at channel locations, it says no. So edit channel locations. And then it tells us, do you want to look up channel coordinates using a template file? And the answer is no. We don't want to do that because our channel labels here in that case are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's no standard names that that could be used to figure out their location. If we press OK or if we press cancel, it's the same thing. So basically here, so there's no channel location, it just creates one channel with name E1. And here we have a channel file associated with this data set. So to load it, we're gonna press read locations. We go into sample lock, where was our data file. We go to sample data, and then we go to EEGLAB_chan32.lock, and that's the data, that's the electrode location associated with this data set. We'll leave EEGLAB auto detect the type of channel location, and then now we can plot them in 2D and in 3D. And we press OK. And now if we look at the main interface, channel locations reads yes. So this is the end of part two. In part three, we will talk about re-referencing and then sampling EEG data.